This is something I never thought I would have to say. Elon Musk is not going to engineer you cat girls. Most of you will be apologists when it comes to this, claiming that this trend to glorify Elon Musk as a tech daddy who opened a portal to the anime dimension is just people being ironic. Perhaps you are a participant in this trend, but we're going to put the pin back in that grenade for a moment. I shall start with an introduction and an apology. I, the writer, go by Cherry Boy Writer around these parts. However, I, Calliope, am the speaker for this video for a variety of material conditions. In this wild west known as the internet, you got a pretty fine collection of nice, tame people running around this here YouTube channel, myself included. However, as with all cowboys, they need an attack dog with a vicious bite. For context, back around October of 2018, Elon Musk, multi-billionaire CEO of Tesla, made a tweet saying that he liked anime. As you can imagine, having our collective degenerate hobby of anime validated by some rich fuck sent Twitter fans into a tailspin of joy. He responded in memes as well as talked about some of the anime he liked. Evangelion being one of them made way too much damn sense, so that's why he had this video now. Perfect chance for us to expose it both. For quite some time, the other Ronin and some of my friends have been pushing me to make an Evangelion video. I've always hated the show, even since hearing about it. Perhaps the worst part about my experience watching it was that it was just about as headache inducing as I expected. Unfortunately, it seems that I've fallen into the Greek trap of trying to escape destiny, and now it's come back around to stare me in the face. If you're of the opinion that Elon Musk is okay, or you're an Evangelion fan, then mash the dislike button now, because we have a lot to talk about, and the first response humans have to truth is always to reject it. Part 1. Elon Musk, the neoliberal supervillain. Truth be, we are far from the first to talk about how awful Elon Musk is as a human being. If anything, we come late to talk about this issue. However, the anime community, due to its escapist tendencies, is still far from reaching its political awakening. So here's a question for you, viewer. When I say the word supervillain, what sort of image comes to your mind? Perhaps it's a sneering megalomaniac bent on destruction, as so overrepresented in media. Maybe he has some sort of tragic backstory about his suffering as a child and he's mad at humanity, or whatever. That's a decent enough framing for a traditional conception, but mine is slightly different. When I see a supervillain, I see three things. I see someone privileged enough to never have suffered with having not to eat for extended periods of times because he just wasn't able to acquire food. I see someone hoarding immense amounts of wealth and power. Instead of improving working conditions for his employees, he makes them worse and sets up a charity work not even a fraction of his collective wealth, so that he has an excuse to say, "I contributed." And more than anything, I see an unfettered egotist with the gall to say that everything he has achieved is a result of his own individual hard work, instead of giving credit to the thousands of years of innovation and his countless employees that developed the technology he claims to have made, repackaged, and then sold to you as some sort of generous god. To me, a supervillain is a wholly incompetent man who leeches and steals the work of others, and then asks you to love him for it. That man, like so many other self-made capitalists, is a man like Elon Musk. Understand that Elon Musk doesn't give a fuck about you. He's rich, literally, why would he? What has he given you in exchange for your hard-earned money other than some cars that break down faster than they should because of planned obsolescence? He's made advancements in the green car technology that we wouldn't have without him, so you say. First of all, that's bullshit. The market was trending that way regardless, and he just rode the wave. None of his success is his own. Secondly, let's just run down a list of his accomplishments. Elon Musk heavily discouraged, if not threatened, his employees to not unionize, so he can continually exploit them for greater profit. He wasted incredible amounts of money, money that could have gone to better working conditions, or foreign aid, or investing in infrastructure to launch a fucking car into space. Elon Musk wanted to create a website to rate journalists because he feels like they attacked Tesla with fake news, while simultaneously claiming that distrust of journalists led to Trump's election. Could it just be that the media also attack him personally with the horrible slur of billionaire? Oh dear, does he not want to hear that? Elon Musk wants to colonize Mars? Elon Musk called a British cave diver who risked his life to save children in Thailand a pedophile. Christ, it just doesn't stop with this asshole. Elon Musk wants to waste potentially billions of dollars to develop a mecha? No, I don't care if that's a goddamn joke. First of all, you know if you gave him encouragement, not your money, he already has that, he would totally do it. Second of all, are you trying to kill more people in countries that aren't yours? Thirdly, the square cube law would immediately fuck that idea out of existence. And finally, and perhaps most importantly, we have only 12 years to contain global climate change before ecological catastrophe. Actually, no, it's even less than that, because scientists found that the oceans are warming even faster than that, so we have even less time. Do you remember that? Do you remember any of this? Are you too busy escaping into isekai worlds to care about your own? Or do you actually believe that this is all just some simulation? And yet, people praise this ego-driven maniac despite time and time again that him and others of his ilk have proven themselves shallow, incompetent, and borderline sociopathic. At worst, instead of doing something productive, people submit to this nihilistic attitude of, I'm going to die anyway, so I'll just cover it up with memes. I think one of the hosts of the Majority Report said it best.
The thing with Elon Musk is you take all of these structural things, which I wish people could talk about instead of looking for a billionaire to save them, which is the big structural problem. And then you get specifically with this guy, and it's like, I mean, it's just all hat and no cattle, right? Like, Tesla's right. A cool car. That ain't solving global warming. Some rich people in LA having a car that might light on fire is not solving a structure.
It was government subsidized.
And it was government well, that's the other major thing. The guy, he's a government contractor, which I don't have any beef with. But like, even
you
just
should own it and be proud of it.
Right, own it and be proud of it. And then he's also militantly anti-union.
Part 2. Irony is unhealthy, kiddos. I hate irony. Even on the surface level, I usually find most ironic jokes and memes more pointless, if not cringeworthy. So forgive me if the humor of making memes about the things Elon Musk claims he wants to do is lost on me. But you want to know what I really hate about irony? It's that all too often it's used to normalize things that should not be normalized. I don't want to spend too much time on this topic since Innuendo Studios just recently added another video to his alt-right playbook series about postmodern conservatism called The Card Says Moop. But when people make ironic jokes about everything, I'm always left wondering, if this is all a joke to you, when will you actually take things seriously? Until it's right in your face and you physically cannot avoid it anymore? And that largely seems to be the attitude I see when even the issue of the planet being actually fucked comes up. People just want to shrug their shoulders and say, have fun until you die, and leave it to the Tony Stark CEOs in the shiny buildings to save us in time, since after all, I don't have the power to change it myself. This sort of devil-may-care attitude to the actual death of the planet makes me nothing but sick. You have to be the improvement you want to see, because even if Yahweh flooded the earth again for human beings being shit, do you really think a multi-billionaire who's never heard of your name is going to let you in on the arc? Forget making you a cat girl, Elon Musk wouldn't make you a sandwich. Understand that by spreading these ironic defeatist memes and ironic glorification memes for guys like Elon Musk, you're sedating yourself and others into complacency. After all, what you intend the joke to mean doesn't matter in the slightest. It's about the material effect your actions have on the world. Part 3. Evangelion, Degeneracy, and the Holy Grail. Dear viewer, do you really want to know what forced my hand to combine these two topics I desperately wanted to avoid at all cost? It wasn't this hilariously good title for the video. It wasn't just Elon Musk being Elon Musk. That's all completely ignorable. It was, in fact, seeing this image right here of Elon Musk photoshopped as Gendo Ikari, followed by a profound sense of disappointment that reminded me both of everything about the techno-billionaire daddy phenomenon and the messages of Evangelion. Well, I say messages, but Evangelion only manages to say one thing throughout his 24 episodes of runtime. Again, I've always hated the show, but not solely because I think the show is mediocre in almost every regard. When it comes to the story of Evangelion itself, the show is completely undermined by the endless amounts of bad ideas Anno puts into it. The Christian symbolism, from what I understand, is confirmed to be all half-baked, only there to add some aesthetic flair. And you know, honestly, the only semi-decent religion is Buddhism anyways. Something that Shinji desperately needed in his life to be less of an emotional train wreck. The other issue with the show is that it's all based in Freudian psychology. And if you want to talk about having the lowest amount of credibility when it comes to talking about psychology, it would be unironically using the Freud was right meme as an argument. The only other thing Evangelion has beyond that's to its credit is a lot of emotional driven character moments that I can see why people heavily relate to it. Unfortunately, all the characters I happen to like in the show are hated by the show itself. So, just so I'm not 100% hate bashing the show, here is a list of things in order I actually really like from Evangelion. Toshi, shame he's dead. Gendo, for being the only person in the show with a functioning brain between his shoulder blades. And that one time Shinji drank tea and was a savage to Misato. That was fucking hysterical. Why couldn't I have had that Shinji the entire time? And that's it. Then, when it finally came to the much talked about ending of the show, the only message that the show imparts that isn't couched in a mountain of armchair intellectualism is that the answer to your emotional problems is to be an individual and take pride in that. Because by being your own person, you'll be able to see the entire world you weren't able to before. And as a final message for a show, that's incredibly weak. However, I say weak, but I don't say incorrect. Believe it or not, despite all my vitriol for the show, I do not think that's actually the worst thing that you could possibly say to someone who's attracted to this show. Personally, I abjure individuality, because it's become bolted on with so much meaningless crap that in popular usage, it's just become a justification to be a degenerate. And that really is my biggest issue with Evangelion. Not the show so much, which I could have ignored and just written off entirely as not my thing, but the rabid fans who are overwhelmingly degenerate freaks. I've had a lot of interaction with Eva fans since getting into anime, and found that if they aren't into politics, they desperately need the Buddha in their life. If they are into politics, I find that they give fucking Ayn Rand credit of all people. Seriously, I wish I had screenshots to contextualize this, because I cannot make this stuff up. But honestly, this is entirely to be expected, when this show somehow breeds people to languish in their own individuality. Although, from what I understand, Hideaki Anno hates this just as much as I do. So clearly something got lost in translation, from the show's content to the fanbase. A good representation of this melancholic self-dramatization is hiding in public in his video called Evangelion, I Feel Sick, as well as his other ones on the series, but this one in particular gives me a migraine. Let me tell you something about individuality that your friends, family, government, and basically anyone else won't tell you. It only serves one function, to diagnose problems. After all, if you're just another minor drone complying with the system and never stopping to question things, how much of your own life are you really living? Being an individual gives you a more unique perspective, both to your own life and to the world around you. So yes, if someone is having a hard time with their personal problems, developing some sense of identity is probably going to benefit them to see things differently. However, I have to stress this next point. Despite what the liberal humanism cult of the world will tell you, the individual is not a monolith. Just because you choose to decide something doesn't mean it's not wrong. And I think a good example of this is, again, another one of Hiding in Public's videos, called Shogo Makashima Was Right, where he unironically stands behind the opinion that the titular character Shogo Makashima did nothing wrong, a character who killed multiple people and also slit an innocent girl's throat in front of the main protagonist, because, wow, my society makes me feel bored. Are you serious right now? Listen, I like psychopaths just as much as the next guy, because it's a well-made show. Maybe even good, considering that at the end, the civil system still stands. So, Gennaro Ibuchi understands that human beings need order. But Shogo Makashima was not right, at all. And if I see you supporting him, I really am going to avoid you on the streets. But let's bring this right back around to full circle. Elon Musk and this image of him as Gendo. Why does this bother me so much? I'll tell you. It's because this combination is a contradiction of the highest order. On the one hand, you have Evangelion, a show advocating you to be your own person and find the answers to your own problems. On the other, you have the anime community's ironic glorification of Elon Musk as the billionaire techno daddy that's going to give them everything they've always wanted so that they don't have to. What the anime community has unconsciously done is morph the image of Elon Musk to the bringer of anime to the 3D realm. And they turned him into their own version of the Holy Grail from Persona 5, a massive entity for them to dump all of their wishes onto and hope that he will grant them what they've always wanted. Genetically engineered cat girls. Does no one else see this as unhealthy? Sacrificing your individuality and thus your creative energy to a fictionalized possibility. No, not even a fictionalized possibility. A joke about a fictionalized solution to the train wreck of a world we live in. YouTuber Mexi recently had this to say about reclaiming creativity for radical purposes.
Creativity right now is just how to create the maximum amount of decadent, useless crap that the market will actually bear. But I think it is so vitally important to reclaim creativity for revolutionary purposes. And this is the time to do it. We got 12 years. We're going to have to get creative, folks.
If you hate interaction with people so much and living in the real world, why not pull together your efforts and genetically engineer your own superior race of cackerels and leave the planet to them? But no, that's too hard, right? You have a chef at your part-time job with no security for tomorrow. So that's right, anime community. Keep normalizing this sociopathic fuckwit who wasted millions of our dollars and resources on this planet to launch a car into space. Normalize the decadent neoliberal wealth inequality he flaunts as people starve in the same country he lives in. Normalize the abhorrent working conditions, the animators who can barely eke out a living, and normalize the fact that most of you are sitting at a computer in your room with no economic prospects and dreading going to work tomorrow because you know your social anxiety will weigh on your neck and your paycheck will never be enough to support your lifestyle. Normalize all of this with a funny meme of Elon Musk smoking pot with his waifus, ironically of course, and thus free of the blame of being complicit in this fucked up world you hate. I hate Evangelion, but there's one thing the show is absolutely right about. You're so fucked up.